competition from the 26th edition of the Winter Universiad. We're reacting to Tino and the Italian Dolomites. These markets are going strong as wheat. There's a great chronic atmosphere all around. While the beautiful weather is really bringing out the best and the most perfect corners of the world. As the men emerge for their second event of this Universiad in 1500 meters. Mecca Giacomo Nenzi had already claimed Italy's first ever medal in 500 meters on Saturday. And he was one of the favorites of this event. Italia up against Zhu Kyong-yong of South Korea in his heat. Zhu stopping the clock at 1 minute 14.74 seconds to grab the bronze medal, but put to the silver by Nenzi. That was 0.2 of a second. But that be good enough to take gold. Last to take to the track with Japan's Taro Kono and Jan Szymanski of Poland. Very much a man in form after taking the gold medal in the 5,000 metres on Friday. The Japanese starting well, just about keeping in touch with Szymanski in the early stages. As the laps wound on, it was the pole that started to stamp his authority on this event. Szymanski actually behind Nenzi on the clock through the first two laps. In the tank for the latter stages. University School of Physical Education in Poznan man really gliding through the gears over the last two laps. Well, Kondo hit the wall, he would wind up down in 13th place. Nothing to stop Szymanski though, he stopped the clock at 1 minute 14.8 to take gold on only 3/4 of a second. Szymanski, the man of the moment there, with two goals from two starts here in Trentino. He'll look to make it a golden triple in the 1,000 metres on Tuesday.
500 metri maschili. Ladies and gentlemen, these conclude.
Now to the ladies and their third event of this meet, the always explosive 500 metres. South Koreans claimed this title the last two times it was held in the university at 2007 and 2009. And it was no surprise to see Min and Park Seung-joo sitting in fourth and third position respectively after the first round. In this event, an aggregate over two rounds taken into account to decide the final positions. Very much a work in progress, having finished in only 31st place in the 2010 Winter Olympics in Vancouver, Canada. Our Park came 39th at last year's World Cup. Again, a touch slower than a compatriot Park. They imagined an aggregate of 79.17 seconds, with Han just 28 hundredths
behind.
Final time,
Park 39.29,
Han 39.46. Anticipated by the home fans, with his own Yvonne Del Dossier based at the University of Innsbruck, bringing in a 19 hundredths lead over another Korean, Kim Hyun-young, into the skate for gold. The start also crucial in this event, but Del Dossier's challenge over almost before it started, thanks to that stutter, and then fall just a few strides in. Del Dossier would eventually get back up and finish the race, only in time to finish 17th out of the 24 in midfield. While Kim, based at the Korea National Sports University in Seoul, grabbed her opportunity with both blades. Her time of 39.22 seconds, fastest 500 of the day. With an aggregate of 79.03 seconds, will be enough to take gold by mere 40 hundredths.
43.64.
The South Koreans continue their recent domination of this event then, with their third gold in a row, and done in fine style too, with a clean sweep for the podium ahead of a pair of Russians, Angelina Velikova and Julia Pashireva.
It is.
Ski Cross is back on the Universiade program for just the fourth time this year. On Sunday saw the ski crossers take to the slopes of Monte Mondone, situated just 20 kilometres from Trento. Not the first time in Trentino, final dominated by the Russian team, but only Belgium's Liska Groenix able to break up their monopoly of a four-woman field, and only just scraped it.
Sunday night with the ladies' free programme. The surf is perfect. The Trento ice rink is Bueno took to the ice. The Japanese student from Kansai University in Osaka sitting in a very positive second place after the short programme. Hoping to carry on a strong Japanese tradition in this event. Having won four titles in a row, but coming up just short in Turkey 2 years ago with the silver medal. Slightly scruffy skate here, only be good enough for sixth in this section. Fifth overall, 146.2 points. Lena Glebova is a seven-time national champion in this event, also hoping to improve on her seventh place finish 2 years ago in Turkey. For a poor short programme, eventually cost her a chance of a medal. The Estonian, based at Tallinn University, chose Strange from the Cleopatra soundtrack for her free programme this year, really getting some polish. Breaking the 100-point barrier with an aggregate of 152.92 and a shot at a spot on the podium. Sofia Mishina was one of three Russians in the field trying to get their hands back on a title. Surprisingly, one since Rina Shatrup struck gold in Zakopane 12 years ago. Mishina could only manage 16th in the 2012 Russian Championship, and certainly developed since then. Still only 18 years old, the first year of Russia, and chose the Dance of Gars by Kobe Sassar for the third program. Third best display of the night, put up a total 154.89 and guarantee herself a medal. Valentina Masha is very much the darling of the Italian crowds here in Trentino. TV reporter in her spare time on studying in Milan. Also a four-time national champion, has finished as high as 8th in the World Championships and 5th in the Europeans in the past. Masha producing a routine for the Verb and Finesse measures, and third place on the short programme. This display, in fact, the best of the night. And good enough for an aggregate of 160.18 points. Sofia Bojokova came into the free programme having come out on top of the short programme and then had to cope with the pressure of being the favourite to take the gold medal. Currently, Scott is a teacher at Trent University and on certain teams have learned to cope with that pressure. Her routine for Bacchanal and Samson of the line was just enough to hold on to the gold. Second gold in Trentino for Russia in the final figure skating event. So close to the Masha, second Russian machine, and just a jump.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the victory ceremony.
Women return to the mountains for their second alpine event of this Universiade in Trentino. Perfect conditions once again prevailed in Passo San Pellegrino. The Pista Nuova Cima Uomo hard packed, the brilliant sunshine enduring perfect visibility. And the 37 starters would need that visibility too as they tried to negotiate 41 turns, a drop of 520 metres between the starting hut and the finishing area. Valentina Shilara Rossi had the honour of being the first out of the gate. The nerves were jangling as the University of Genova student made her Universiade debut. Shilara Rossi with no real way of judging her pace against her competitors, but still putting everything she had into this run in front of a home crowd. Setting a stiff...
E chiude la Shilara Rossi, 1:29.30.
Barbara Kantarova was one of the later starters, having come ninth in the downhill, a time of 1:29.29. At that stage, Valentina Galenkova has been in fine form at these championships, showing great power in the downhill as the Russian claimed the silver medal there, and so hopes were of another visit to the podium in the slightly more technical Super G. Galenkova is faster than any of the front runners on the top half of the piece, but slightly losing her way this time on the slightly faster lower section. Stopping the
chiude seconda, 1:29.22.
But which one?
Quindi al comando resiste Carolina Rapek, Polonia poi.
Carolina Rapek, who is expected to be a strong contender for medals here in Italy, having bagged a silver in the Super G and a bronze in the giant slalom 2 years ago in Turkey. The pole also topped the timesheets in practice for Friday's downhill before underperforming her way, relatively disappointing bronze medal in that event. This time she fared slightly better though, seventh out of the starting gate, but consistently quick all the way down the mountain.
Prima! 1:28.58. Quindi cambia la classifica al comando, la polacca Carolina Rapek.
Giulia Borgetti had other ideas though, the Italian based at the University of Milano, and hoping to become the third Italian to win this event. That's after Alessandro Berni in 2003. Giulia Genesini, 2007. Both of those wins also inspired the skiing of home and snow. Borgetti fast at the top, and then super late on the first attempt of section.
Prima l'italiana, 1:28.43.
Away the gold medal from Rapek.
First place, erste place for Giulia Borgetti.
Italy topping the alpine skiing medal table then after
we'll be presented two goals by
the first second medal of this game's opponent, but still waiting to hit the goal itself.
Signori, si chiude con questa immagine. Cross-country mixed sprint real is a relative newcomer to the winter university. They're going to be competitive for the first time 2 years ago in Turkey. Slovakia took the gold medal. After the heats, two teams from Russia, Poland, and Sweden have the third and two from Finland, Japan, Norway, and Ukraine.
Sono al presepe.
Display with the rifle and a clear shoot in the pro section represented the perfect start. That meant she now had an imposing 8.7 second lead at that point. Fifth place at the 2010 Olympics, 15k individual event. Tatiana Semenova was another to endure a disastrous time with the rifle in the 15k individual event 2 days ago. Six targets on her way to a 10th place finish.
Russia much better today, though. But 5.5, so it's a opening time of the race. Novakovska Zemniak very much in her comfort zone in this event. One missed target to the more difficult standing shoot, threatening to derail her with her speed over the snow. She still emerged in first place after doing her penalty loop. Semenova is enjoying an even better day on the range, though. Perfect points again at her second visit to the range. And despite her relatively slow speed over the snow, she was still sitting in third place. She just missed one target all day. That's enough for a second place finish. Next to our fences, it's a good speed. Much like it compared to the
cerchiamo di fare festa nuovamente insieme, grazie a tutti e a più